What's very disappointing is that there are still people who do not believe that we landed on the moon, that Kubrick something had something to do with it. Somehow Stanley Kubrick's name always comes up. And yeah. I find it ridiculous that people still feel this way, that it didn't happen.
Yeah, this is something that Don and I have encountered a lot at film festivals, where people, in Q&As, people ask questions. And one question that always comes up is about that very thing, about, you know, was it faked? And do you guys actually believe it happened? And we're always at great pains to emphasize something which I think most people forget, which is that in 1969, we absolutely had the technology to go to the moon, but we did not have the technology to fake going to the moon.
Yes, that's exactly right.
I mean, if you look at if you watch like 2001: A Space Odyssey, it's gorgeous as a work of art. It looks nothing like the reality of being on the moon in 1/6G, right? It's got people walking around slowly in traditional fashion.
And nobody's really duplicated.
No,
people bouncing around on the moon look like.
No, they haven't.
They claimed to have done. The other interesting thing was, you know, that the moon landing was shot in HD, but we didn't receive it in HD. We had just our 300, you know, lines per inch, you know, cruddy televisions, mostly black and white at the time, right? But it was shot in HD. That's why we have so many, beautiful films after. But I really feel that your film, The Landing, and First Man would make a great double feature.
When these guys came to me and told me that Damien Chazelle had decided for his next project, after having done such a beautiful job with Whiplash and La La Land, that his next project was going to be a story about Neil Armstrong, one of the only two Apollo astronauts that I've actually met. I've met the first and the last man on the moon, which
wow.
is Neil Armstrong, and also Eugene Cernan when I was there at South by Southwest. And he was there with a film called Last Man, which, have you seen?
Wow.
That's an excellent documentary.
Yes,
by the way.
Yeah.
And so when they told me that, I'm like, fantastic, you know, because there's so many things that are happening that are NASA-related right now. As you know, there's the 60th anniversary. We're about to put U.S. astronauts back in space from U.S. soil on a U.S.-built ship, where we've just introduced those astronauts to the public.
You know, drama is about contrast. And First Man and The Landing provide a very stark contrast when you're looking at the two characters, Neil Armstrong and Bo Cunningham, one representing the better angels, I would say, and one perhaps representing the darker angels. So you're right. I believe it'd be a great double feature because you would really get the two sides. And the two movies are, as you know, are going after a completely different game. I mean,
right, no, you can't.
So,
that's what I'm saying. You can't.
Yeah.
It's the same space, but you can't compare them. I mean, it's to me, The Landing is like a great Twilight Zone episode, right? Like, just and to be clear, like about. So you guys made a short film, The Landing, in the early '90s. What, 90?
94, 95, and right after we finished that, we immediately started talking about how we might be able to make that into a feature. And one of the things we talked about was that if we waited long enough, then there might be some really interesting things that we could do. And then around 2015, David basically came to us and said, I think this is the time to do this. I mean, everybody's still alive. We should actually act on these ideas.
Don, also, it's the fact that you're in that footage. You're in the recreated footage, right? You're in it. And then we're seeing you now, you know, in, quote, present day, although present day is technically the late 90s, right?
Or correct, yeah.
Something like that. It I mean, you could not have planned it better if you planned it that way.
Oh,
I mean,
no, we out-boyhood boyhood by about
right, exactly.
12 years. They were like 12 years and we're like 25, so...